Hello, I'm Daniel. In the past 2 years, we see large language models, LLMs, operate tools and systems for the user. For example, I can describe what I want to change with an image, and Visual ChatGPT will operate its arsenal of tools for me. Even the entire Windows 11 can be automated if I just chat with Microsoft Copilot. In both cases, an LLM agent sits on top of an underlying system, forming the application. But if this is all you do, it's only a small patch to our existing way of doing things. Neither example here scratches the surface of what's possible with LAUI. LAUI stands for LLM Agent User Interface, a new avenue of UI research that we are putting forward with our position paper. As an overview, in LAUI, given the user and the underlying system, an LLM agent implements emerging tailored interaction schemes during the use time. Consequentially, this allows novice users to harness complex tools. This allows designers to provide features without design time organization. What do I mean? In application design, there's this challenge to balance capability against customizability against learnability. We've come to agree that one size fits all is bad, so people have been making their apps more customizable. But that adds to the learning curve, because for each user there's only ever going to be a part of your customizability that's relevant. Displaying anything more only hurts. In this sense, this kind of customizability is still one size fits all, just on a higher level, because the designer can only offer the same customizable UI to everyone. Does it have to be the user who's responsible for customization? We emphasize the concept of workflow. We define a workflow to be the scheme or protocol or pattern or mode of usage or interaction. Notice, even when the underlying system is fixed, there exist different workflows, each suitable for different user needs, preferences, and usage environments. Therefore, to search for optimal workflows, you need two input variables: the system capabilities as well as the user's needs. In the conventional way, the application designer has to explore an often intractable configuration space as best they can, and imagine the user experience associated with each explored configuration, implement some of them, and test a few. Then the designer settles down with a structure to present the possible configurations in making a GUI. It is then the user's responsibility to learn the GUI, learn the system, and search for a workflow. In contrast, LAUI is initialized to be an expert of the underlying system via prompting or fine-tuning. LAUI then chats with the user to clarify their goals, preferences. The user and LAUI then work together to explore workflows as LAUI tweaks the system configurations, altering its GUI and multimodal feedback behaviors. Here, note the difference between design time imagined workflows versus use time emergent workflows. It's the sad truth that the designer doesn't have access to the individual user. This forces any personalization effort at design time to only address the aggregate. Instead, more decision should happen at use time, when the user is known. what we learned is that the designer should really let go of more than we expected. And here's how. Before LLM, the designer is responsible for developing system capabilities and constructing a metaphor or schema around their system. One that the user uses as the mental model to think about your system by. The regular LLM assistant we have today sits on top of that metaphor layer, controlled and preconceived by designers, limiting their capabilities. What we learned from Lowy is that the designer should really let go of the metaphor layer. Lowy will be in charge of that during the use time, when the user is a known variable. Then the designers can publish loosely organized or even unorganized features during design time. That's what we did. Here, we share our story of how we applied Lowy to our underlying system, the Music X Machine. Music X Machine is a music tutoring software hardware system with the goal of teaching the user general musicality on the flute. And look, it has haptic gloves that controls your fingers. In essence, the haptic feedback is one of the many modalities we have, and we emphasize on the real-time multimodal interaction with the learner. This system offers many parameters to be tuned, and that is good in the sense that we have fine-grained specification of the learning environment, since different combination of parameters train different skills at different difficulty levels. But this many parameter configuration makes the system really complex. Here are some example parameters. When should the glove move your fingers? If it's on note start, then you just relax. If it's on your mistake, then you play the piece actively to receive corrections. After haptic guidance, should we free the finger or keep the finger in the correct positions? They require different kind of active-passive engagement. For visual feedback, should we show the notes in the score or the student's performance, or both overlaid? They give rise to drastically different self-supervising behaviors. Finally, should we withhold future notes in the score? That depends on the intended learning goal. Is it song memorization or sight playing from a novel score? There are so many more parameters that I haven't mentioned. Again, we're thankful that we have this level of fine-grained control over the system, but how are we going to expose them to the user? In the conventional way, the designer would have to think clearly about how their features interact and design a GUI. Even then, the user would have to learn the system before they start learning the music. What a shame. How does modern-day industrial complex applications handle this problem? Only via sacrificing potentials. We had to oversimplify our features until it's possible to organize them and present a workable structure, a mental model for the user. Lowy essentially makes that sacrifice unnecessary because it encourages the developer, the designer, to publish loosely organized or even unorganized features. Then at use time, Lowy will filter those features for relevant ones given the user, and then propose metaphors, organizations, and mental models on the fly. That's what we did. We added Lowy to Music X Machine on top of the GUI with access to the APIs. We obtained FluteXGPT, where the student chats with an LLM have multimodal interaction with MusicX Machine, and the LLM agent controls MusicX Machine. Here are more details you can ask about in Q&A. Let's watch a video demo to see FluTex GPT in action.
Welcome to today's music training, Dan. I'm FluTex GPT, your music teacher.
Hello. I want to learn Sally Garden. Can we practice that today?
Absolutely, Dan. Sally Gardens is a great choice. Let's load that song into the MusicX machine. Would you like to listen to the reference audio of Sally Gardens before we start practicing? It could be a helpful refresher.
Actually, no need.
Sure, let's begin with the fixed tempo adaptive mode, just to see what you can do. Please try to play the song following the playhead in the metronome. Whenever you make a mistake, your haptic gloves will fix them. I'm turning on visual KR feedback. Your performance will be reflected on the score in real time.
Let's go then.
Great, let's start the practice session. It seems like the song is a bit challenging at this tempo. Let's slow it down a bit to give you more time to think and react. We'll play it at 70% of the original tempo. Now, let's focus just on the first four bars. We'll practice this segment until you're comfortable with it. Let's hear the reference audio of the current segment. Are you ready for another go?
Yeah, let's give it another try.
Alright, let's start the practice session again. You'll have more time now, so take it easy.
Wait, this is too slow. This is not exciting anymore.
I understand that you want to keep the excitement, Dan. However, when practicing a new song, it's important to slow down initially. This allows you to focus on each note and get the fingering right. Once you're comfortable with the notes, you can gradually increase the tempo back up. Trust me, the excitement will return as your performance improves. Shall we continue with the slower tempo?
I see. Let's start slowly then.
Great understanding, Dan. Let's practice the first four bars at the slower tempo. Remember, accuracy first, speed later. Excellent work on the notes, Dan. Every note is correct now in terms of pitch. However, it seems that the timing still needs some work. To help with this, let's use the force mode. This mode will guide your fingers strictly according to the song's rhythm. It's like dancing with a lead dancer. You just follow the lead. Let's give it a try, shall we?
Cool, let's do the force mode then.
Dan, your timing has improved significantly, and you're getting the notes perfectly. Now, let's move on to the next four bars of the song. Let's switch back to the fixed timing adaptive mode, which is essential for sight playing. Alright, the haptic gloves will only correct your mistakes. Try to get as many notes right as you can.
Wait, did you change mode? Which mode are we in?
We're currently using the fixed timing adaptive mode, Dan. Are you ready to continue?
Well, can we switch back to force mode? That was quite nice.
Sure, Dan. Can you tell me why you prefer the force mode at the moment?
I could just relax all my fingers and the gloves have me covered.
I see your point, Dan. However, while the force mode can indeed guide you through the song, the goal of our practice is to help you learn to play on your own. You can't truly learn if you're not actively trying. The fixed timing adaptive mode provides a balance between guidance and freedom. Can we proceed with that mode?
I see. Let's do the adaptive then.
Remember, Dan, we have the visual KR feedback on. You can see your performance reflected on the score in real time. This can help you understand how the notes you're playing correspond to the music sheet. Let's continue with the practice session. Dan, you got all the notes correct, and your timing was nearly perfect. Now, let's move on to the next four bars of the song. Are you ready?
Definitely. Let's give it a go. Actually, can we change the tempo back up to 100%? I think I'm ready.
Sure, Dan. Let's set the tempo back to 100% of the original. Here it goes.
In this demo, the latency is removed via scripting. Also, the script is sampled with human guidance. Alright, what is the one-liner for Laowi? It works with the user to define how to work together next. We encourage the designer to design loosely organized features, making the application more capable. Laowi allows use time emergent workflows, giving rise to application customizability. Consequentially, Laowi unlocks complex tools for novice users. Time for Q&A.